Hi guys, this is Morty, and today I'm gonna be going to Eve. And actually, that's a lie. I'm gonna be going to Gilly because I cannot make it out of Eve through its atmosphere, even though I have far and even though I have atmospheric scoops, which should take enough atmosphere into. But anyhow, I cannot make it, so what happened? On the last episode, I told you guys that I was gonna be going to Jewel, but since I didn't fancy waiting 350 days, I said, fuck it, let's go to Eve instead, that's only at 80 days. So that's what I'm doing. Right now I'm taking off at entirely the wrong direction. I should be pointing east, but when I landed, I forgot about that and I landed pointing west. So now I'm trying to fix that. But since I'm not the smartest person playing this game, I'm also going way too high up. I'm pointing at around 45 degrees up instead of, say, 10. So what's gonna happen in a few moments is that I'm gonna run out of atmosphere because I went way too high, way too fast. So what will end up happening is that I will not have enough horizontal speed to put me into an orbit. At least not with using my atmospheric engines, the turbojets on the Karbonite mod. So I will have to end up getting to orbit using mostly my rocket, my atomic rockets and my Karbonite rockets, which is vastly less efficient. And that's gonna be problematic because I will directly need all that Delta V in the future. Well, by far the biggest reason why I'm gonna flame out soon is because I'm using Ferrum Aerospace, also known as FAR, which, in addition to giving you realistic aerodynamics, what it does is make the atmosphere much thinner. So the practical upshot of that is that I'm running out of atmosphere right now. So when I turn on the thrust, I will end up spinning out of control, like right now. Check that out, spinning like a moron. Luckily, my bottom side of the ship has very powerful RCS that is gonna allow me to point into the right direction, meaning the east, and continue burning using my atomic engines like I am right now. Eventually I made it into a stable orbit, 100 kilometers orbit, and I'm getting my maneuver node set up in order to get to Eve. Regardless of getting to Eve, the most important part of interplanetary travels, which is one of the parts that most new folk to Kerbal Space Program struggle with, are actually the correction burns, because getting an encounter is kinda easy once you know how much to burn, which you can do using ksp.olex.vs or just the Kerbal alarm clock. So correction burns, basically when you get an encounter, you will be way far off. So what you wanna do is get your orbit as close as the planet as you can, usually, so that you don't have to burn a lot of Delta V to get closer. So right now I'm approaching Eve. I already have the encounter set up. So what I do is double click on the planet and zoom in. So then I can, what I'm doing right now, set up a maneuver node and slightly use, you know, making sure that my periapsis is at the height I want it to. This being Eve, and using Ferrum Aerospace, this is very important. I want it to be at something like 60 to 65 kilometers up, so that I can aerobrake at a speed that won't make me explode too readily. With a stock, this wouldn't be a problem, but when you're using Ferrum Aerospace, your planes have a tendency to break when a slight breeze hits them, which is sometimes troublesome. But regardless, if you are any good at this game, in other words, if you are not me, this won't happen. There you go. I just lost all my surfaces, all my control surfaces specifically, so I cannot maneuver in the atmosphere right now, which is a problem in most cases, which I will solve using the big old method of weak loading like a coward. So, second take. I use a higher periapsis and it's going well, so I get confident and I set to pull up so I have more resistance and I aerobrake harder, so then I explode. Yeah, exactly. Brilliant work, huh? So, Surely the third time must be the charm. But it will turn out that I basically grew impatient again, and I tried to make it way too fast, as per usual, so yeah. Well, yeah. Fourth time was actually a charm. This time I just stuck with it. I had a 63 km periapsis, and I just pointed to the prograde vector until the aerobrake was over. And after that was over, I waited to be outside the atmosphere at 90 km up before flipping around and killing the rest of the velocity in order to complete the injection burn, otherwise known as making sure you don't go flying off into the solar system. So far so good. If I hadn't landed on Duna pointing in the wrong direction, and if I had made the correction burn actually correct, this wouldn't have happened. I would have an orbit which isn't 20 degrees off Gilly. So right now I'm correcting that again, which ended up costing me upwards of 500 delta V. All in all, if I took this game with some patience and didn't decide to wing it all the time, I would basically have right now about 1000 to 2000 more delta V, and this will end up not costing me dearly, but almost. I am right now down to below 10% of my total delta V, as you can see in the resources window up in the right corner. Thankfully, Gilly is really tiny. It's barely larger than an E-class asteroid, meaning that it has a very forgiving gravity. It's even a fraction of Minmus, so basically as long as you can fart, you can probably land there and get back out rather easily. Actually, Gilly is probably the only place in the system where it's harder to actually stick to the ground than it is to take off. You will see it in a few moments. I actually was able to get into space by bouncing using my landing gear. That was really a first for me. That hadn't ever happened. You could probably say that, well, yes, I've been playing this game for it long enough to know that Gilly doesn't really have that much of an atmosphere, but honestly, I don't really come here often. This is not really a spot I like about the system. I much rather go to Jule and have fun there. So this is like probably the second or third time I come to Gilly, and I didn't quite remember this place being so stupid. Now, check this out. I'm coming down as soft as I can, and the acceleration is tiny. Look at that, nothing at all. I can flip, and I'm almost hovering above the ground with barely any acceleration, up to the point where when I turn on my RCS and try to slow it down, it's actually powerful enough that the following happens. I actually fly away. Check that out. Yeah, sure, I have like 200 newtons worth of thrust at the bottom of my plane, but that's just stupid. So here I'm bouncing away. In this attempt, the methodology was basically just let the ship crash against the surface, and I just bounced it fucking up. My RCS at the top isn't really strong enough to pull me down, so I will have to wait. Thank God for you, I have the ability of editing power in my arsenal, so you don't have to watch the longer than 10 actual minutes of my life that I spent bouncing up and down the surface of Gilly. But yeah, anyhow, eventually I made it, which was cool because you can see I have almost no fucking fuel left. And once I made it, it was just a matter of deploying the drill and drilling. Gilly, thankfully, does have some hotspots, but I kind of forgot about this, so I just landed wherever, which was unfortunate, but ever since the latest version of Karbonite, now drilling and fuel converting is on rails, so you do not have to interrupt your time warping in order to be able to do it. So it's, you know, even easier than before. at least until they implement the drills breaking, or however Robert Deere goes about doing that. So, well, on the next episode I'm probably be going to Moho, and after that I'm gonna be heading to Dres or to Jewel. I will have to see where the next transfer window takes me. I hope you enjoyed this, and see you soon.